I dig the selective coloring, similar to like SimCity.
A Daniel Candle picture. Welcome to Tales of the Crypt.
It's a cool intro. This might be exactly what I need. Because, like, I wanted to, like, Life is Strange, but I couldn't get into it. My frame rate's suffering a little. Is that death? Is that the devil? We're playing Skyrim in black and white, folks. We're just wandering around another dungeon here. A lot of levels. Omuk, one voice actor, apparently. He's really, really good. Trust me, guys, he's great. And this is what the average New York City apartment looks like. I think it's pretty accurate. Why is it whenever, like, there's, like, a...
Here, it's your turn.
Decrepit mattress. It's always got to be, like, partially slumped against something. Can't just be flat on the ground. Okay. So movement's a little...
Get me out of here, please.
We're sharing the floss this time. Okay. Time to clean those teeth. So there's no mouse as far as I can tell. I just basically walk up to these items.
If we don't escape, I'll be punished. I've been bad.
That's cool.
Don't worry, I can do this.
I guess I don't need a mouse.
What if you can't? I'll be punished. Just like Juliet. You see? One down. That just leaves yours and the one on the door. I'll be punished. I've been bad. I'll be punished. It's okay.
If you keep talking, I'm gonna let you. I wonder if there's an actual time element to this, or can I go check out the bloody cell that was once Juliet's? Alright, I can't walk any faster. Who's that? What's up, little kid? We're not saving you, apparently. Uh-oh. Oh my gosh, there's a time thing.
Quick, get me out of here! Quick. Be quiet!
Can I just leave him? Alright, I guess we'll save you. Oh my goodness.
What are you doing? Help me, please.
Relax.
It isn't time to open both locks.
Oh, shoot.
Yes, quick.
No, let's get out of here. Sorry, kid.
What are you doing? Help me, please.
It's kill or be killed.
I don't know. I'm gonna be punished.
You said you were bad, so it feels like you... You feel like you deserve it. I didn't even get out of here. Now he's gonna rat me out. Now I'm playing Amnesia.
She's there.
See? I was ratted out.
She's been really bad, hasn't she?
Boom. A little out of sync. Hey, RKH. she gonna sing in bullets? Yeah, she is apparently.
Coming to Fox this Thursday.
And now we wait.
The end. Until episode 2. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Bye.
We really wait. The game doesn't see, it runs a little not as optimized. A music shooter. Where are the cops? Is that blood or paint or? This is what sold me on it. I am a sucker for noir and the 40s and black and white and like, oh man, this screen, like this alone, this is why I bought it. And then you add on the whole Telltale aspect that it's like that. Oh, man. Although it reminds me a lot of,
Elliot?
Fahrenheit.
Just a second. Alice, I thought you were on the day shift. Pie?
Well, I just slipped out for a second. This arrived for you at the station.
Thanks. I'll put it in the back room, then I'll get you a slice of pie. Deal?
I'm kind of in a hurry. What kind?
Just have the pie! Okay.
It's a deal.
Yep. Do I get to do anything with the... The music doesn't seem very 1940s-esque. Oh, the walking's so floaty.
It's not much, but I earned it. It's seen better days, like a lot of us.
Oh, you know who that is? That's Geralt of Rivia.
Yes. Where's my burger?
Relax out there, buddy. Listen to him, listen to him. Of course, now he won't. Yeah, it was Al Capone. For tax evasion.
Goddammit!
You know, it's funny, I got breakfast today at a deli.
Goddammit, Ness! You gotta be the slowest waiter in Santa Esperanza!
I guess so. The girls at Happy Doll say you're more of the speedy type. I won't keep you waiting again.
Anyway, they catch the deadbeat robbing the pharmacy, but the... There's no proof, so they hand him over to me.
Elliot, seriously, I don't have much time.
Oh, is this gonna be like... Burger for Officer McGruff or pie for the woman who didn't ask for pie, but I'm insisting she has some blueberry pie?
Take your time. If Jenkins says anything, tell him it's my fault. And let him know that I'll continue to keep his agents waiting until he settles his tab.
You want to play a game of Gwent?
But this is worth getting in trouble for.
To think, I didn't find my true calling until I was in my 50s.
Welcome to Cook Serve Delicious. 1940s style.
And this time, go easy on the chili sauce. Gives me indigestion.
Indigestion? All of the sauce!
Done.
Okay, I tell him, if you confess right now, I finish work on time and everybody's happy.
He's a big hand talker. He talks with his hands.
I get mad, and I have to rearrange your face.
You really said that?
There you go.
And listen to this, Ness. And then I say to him, the doctor will have to work late too, and it'll be your fault. He'll be mad. And when he's done fixing your mug, it'll be so ugly, you'll never get laid again.
He sang, right?
Yeah, like a soprano. And you know what I did next, Ness?
He rearranged his face.
Exactly. You see, criminals are like dogs. By the time they get punished, they forget what they did wrong. But a bust-up face is forever.
I'm Officer Gruff, and my morality is as black and white as this video game.
How much sauce did you put on this thing, you goddamn maniac?
Just enough to make sure you never come back here, Dickinson.
Ah, screw you, Ness.
He even looks like Geralt, like what Geralt would look like if he lived in the 40s and got his hair cut and owned a diner.
Your first time here, right? I like this job, you know? Not because I like serving coffee or food. This job is about understanding people, knowing what they want, what they need. You just have to keep your eyes open. The clothes, the haircut, a little movement. A hand clutching a knife.
Oh, yeah, I saw that.
Don't even think about it. Not because of me. At most, I'd knock out a couple of your teeth before disarming you. The guys you should be worried about are the cops at the other table. They'd keep kicking you in the ribs long after you passed out. You'd be lucky to wake up in a hospital. The question is, what do I do with you now?
Ooh, what should we do, guys? What should we do? I don't know if there's a time limit on this, so you gotta hurry up. This is where hitbox lack of lag makes a big difference. I'm watching the chat. Come on. Kindness. All right.
Buy yourself a suit, son. Get a shave. Get a job. And make a man of yourself. And if you come back here $2. Looking for trouble, you'll find it.
I'm going to hire the guy with the $2 suit. Come on.
You want coffee?
Stop asking me. Stop it.
I forgot to thank you for bringing my pension check.
Well, I saved you a trip.
And a headache. The station's full of Dickinsons. Your dad would be proud of you.
Thanks. But not Jenkins.
Easy there, miss. Slow and steady wins the race.
What? Yeah, she took one bite.
If I don't get some blackberry pie this minute, I'm gonna die before this day's out. Can you help me, sir?
I'm afraid not.
It's too bad. I need something sweet for my last day on Earth.
Blueberry pie? Last slice.
You use almond extract?
Quarter of a teaspoon.
Which brand?
Wow, picky.
I made my own.
Just use the blueberry pie that she barely touched. It's still good.
Do I know you from someplace?
Me? No. But you do know my boss.
That is a bullet. Oh, the place is called Blues and Bullets. I didn't catch on that. Oh, man. Yeah, the dialogue's weird. I can't tell if it's because I don't know who the developers are or where they're from, because sometimes you see games developed in Europe where like English isn't their first language and it just localizes weird. Okay, now he just looks like Max Payne as played by
Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro,
somebody,
Dockers.
Uh-oh, time
Garrison,
to seek.
Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro, Dockers.
Nice location.
Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro, Dockers.
Is he Arya Stark?
The mountain.
Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro,
Dockers. The mountain, Cersei Lannister.
Is that Vinny Jones?
Call your boss. I have business to settle with him.
Can't even enjoy a quiet smoke.
He looks like him, but he's American.
Look, I get it. It's Christmas. You're lonely and you want to end it all. But Santa Esperanza is full of bridges. Why not throw yourself off one of them and leave me in peace?
Tell Capone that Elliot Ness is here. We're going to finish this thing once and for all.
Jeez, I don't get paid enough. Listen, you got it backwards. I'm not here to make my boss come out. I'm here to stop you getting in.
Threaten.
I hope you asked Santa Claus for crutches. Because if you don't do what I say, they're going to be the perfect gift for you.
Maybe I could borrow a pair from your buddy, Dockers. I hear he's never gonna need them again.
Aww, is he dead?
You shouldn't have brought that up.
Oh no? You gonna cry now? Hey, come on. It's Christmas.
Really? That was amazing, because he's drunk.
At the front gate!
How's he not dead?
It's oh, Ness!
Am I shooting?
Put down your weapons. You'll get a fair trial.
Yep, I'm shooting now. Whoop. Headshot. Boom.
That way.
I'm not moving. That's all automatic. It's like I'm playing Area 51 or something. Headshot. God. Got him. Headshot. Where you going? The mouse sensitivity, not too good. On to the next part.
Go ahead.
Oh, this place is so weird. Hey, dead bro. Oh, man. Good thing you parked all of these explosive. Why do we have explosive tanks? Oh, I'm dead. Haven't reloaded once.
We need more men!
What?
Oh. It doesn't help that the frame rate's like
dead.
Super choppy. I actually preferred the pistol. Think about this for a second. He just punched one guy. And now there's been enough bloodshed that Al Capone could definitely get locked away. So that guard really did not react very well. He would have been fired for sure. Can I shoot these red bows and have them explode? They're red. You can't even, like, do the shooting from cover. Man, this is such a weird game. Why would you not take any cover? Why would you shoot your cover? But it's Christmas? Imagine all the paperwork. That's true. That'll probably be why they don't do it. Look at this. I ain't even set half of these fires. Okay, I did set those two fires. You know what's crazy? It's not even like OBS that's dropping the frame rate, because I'm looking over and there's no CPU issue. This is just, I think, the game.
Now who's the gangster? I am Geralt Elliot Ness. Gonna drop this machine gun? It would be too advantageous. We're gonna face off with a pistol. It's empty, but adds to the challenge. Oh, shoot.
Can I do, please do a Max Payne dive? Let's take a look at the painting first. It's a sketch. Al Capone. who fantastic depiction of Al Capone in Boardwalk Empire, which I now want to rewatch. Is Al Capone playing the piano? I don't think he was a good piano player. I'm not a Capone. Up.
Oh. Have any last words?
You come into my house?
Your doorman was kind enough to let me in.
You kill my men.
I didn't know human beings mattered to you.
Would you kill an unarmed man? You, Elliot Ness?
You have my word. I'm not going to kill a man.
Papa!
Vittorio!
Wasn't he deaf?
Are you gonna kill me in front of my son?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to.
That stain right there is all that's left of D'Annunzio. One of my best men. I told him to take care of the butcher on East Main. One of the jerks who've been screwing with me for months. We had to make an example of him. Send a message to the other storekeepers. D'Annunzio ripped out his guts and hung him up with the merchandise.
Your kid's right there.
He did it while the butcher's daughter was watching. Fucking D'Annunzio.
Oh.
There are lines that cannot be crossed. We have to protect the innocence of children. Keep them far, far away from certain experiences.
Tell him to go.
Vittorio stays. He's my son, not a storekeeper's child.
Then shoot him.
If his father dies, at least let him know who to take his revenge on. But that's not gonna happen.
Oh, give me the chance.
Vittorio. His hand's shaking. Booze turns men into cowards. You'll be like your father. Never drink. It's funny, huh? The White Knight of the Volstead Act gets liquored up to kill the king of bootleg booze.
Relax, son. Nobody's going to kill anybody.
Except me, I killed all of those men outside.
I'll introduce you to a girl your age, Vittorio. Her name is Claire Dockers, and she sings like an angel. You two would get along. 2 days ago, Claire's father caught up with yours in a warehouse. Your father was hitting innocent people, and that's not right. He told him to stop, but your father ignored him and pulled out a gun to shoot him. Claire's father was quicker. He drew his gun first and fired, but the bullet jammed. Your father killed Claire's father in cold blood. He kicked him in the face so many times, not even Claire herself would have recognized him.
You'll never prove I killed Dockers.
I know, and that's why I'm here. But now I know I'm better than you.
You killed...
Your father is a murderer, and Claire hasn't stopped crying these last 2 days, all because of him. Never forget that, Vittorio.
Boom, slow-mo bullet.
Hold it! Let him go. Run, Ness, and forget I exist, or I'll have to report what you just did. And I do have witnesses. You hear me, Ness?
You killed like 10 people, 12 people. I like how, since the game's in black and white, they can't really just allow you to assume when it takes place. They have to tell you, we're going back now.
Mm-mm-mm. That's some first-class pie. I appreciate it. Thank you, sir. My car is parked outside. If you could join me as soon as possible, I'll be doubly grateful.
Pay your bill.
Gentlemen,
your bill.
I'm closing up. Time to move along.
So early? What are you talking about, Ness?
Are you serious?
I'm sorry, guys. I have to close up. Today's meal is on the house.
Oh, yeah? Tomorrow's, too. Or I'm not coming back. You got that?
Oh, no.
Whatever you say, Dickinson.
You can tell I'm gruff because I've got stains on my uniform. Nice people are clean.
dungeon in my detective uniform.
That's how a bullet turns into a boomerang.
Take it, maybe? No, okay, we're not gonna take it. We're leaving it right there. What we got here? Was that the guy we just let go? Denbro, that was the person I think you just... Yep. Yep, look at that. You just let him go. There's a killer on the loose now. We gave him $2 and a free ticket. Let's grab a drink. We got here. A little bit of... Wow. Wait. Can I go back to that? We gotta go back to that. $1 for a 2 burgers? Wait, one more time. I gotta read this whole receipt. Burger, 40 cents, 20 cents, 20 cents, and oh my god, that's ridiculous. I wanna pay 20 cents for a burger. A freedom burger, no less. Oh, this is exactly what diners want to see. All right. Half of that was useless. Food to dine for. Oh, you're so funny, Elliot Ness.
At last, Mr. Ness. Please get in.
Where are we going?
A place that's a little too fancy for a guy like you. But if it's any consolation, it's way too fancy for me. Please get in. I can't afford for you to catch a cold.
It looks pretty nice out. Birds are tweeting and... the trees are full of life. You're in what I presume is analogous to Los Angeles. Who's gonna catch a cold? I'm gonna try that one day in the summer. Up. Got some road traffic up ahead. It looks like we're headed for the H building. Good old H. Oh, I think I read about this. I think I know where we're going. I'm not going to spoil it for everybody. Unfortunately, you don't get,
We'll be going up in a couple of minutes. I'll wait for you in the cable car.
Cable car.
Up where?
What do you think? Hindenburg! I believe that is called... Transcoding. Transstreaming. And I think you need to be a Twitch partner to get that. It's not Twitch partner, Hitbox partner. Oh, what's going on over here? Back tattoos. That's it? Just creepy scoping out their backs? Alright. That's super creepy.
The Hindenburg. Her forced landing in New Jersey almost cost the lives of over 100 passengers.
There's that alternate history.
Midair, it would have burned down half the city.
Nope, would have been pretty self-contained. Would have just burned right up, caught on tape and everything, and then nobody would ever use Zeppelins again. Why don't we go back to Zeppelins? Bring them back. I think we have to go to the station? Nice mask. Feel like I'm playing Assassin's Creed a little bit. It's very linear, this game. This guy's never heard of a ramp before. Good job, you're fired. You're fired over there, okay? We told you. One more time, you forget to use the ramp or the elevator and you take the stairs, we're gonna let you go, okay? It's not that hard. We covered in day one.
Hey, Ryan. Owner of Ryan Hotels, the visionary who transformed the Hindenburg into the monument to aeronautical luxury it is today.
I seem to know a lot about the Hindenburg as a hotel for somebody who asked earlier where we were going.
Up where?
Yeah, he didn't even do anything to clean up those bags. He's probably still standing there. Listen, anything else? Nope, okay.
Okay, let's go.
I feel like it's a very Bioshock. Why do you need the lights? Man, the frame rate's so jagged. You dropped something. Business card. Oh, it's just garbage? Okay.
Scared of heights?
Not at all. You?
No.
We're just sitting.
Give me the paper bag, I have one.
No, I'm fine. I'm just gonna puke on the people down there.
Bleh. Michael Clark
Duncan. Go.
No, that's not Michael Clark Duncan.
Higher than the clouds.
That's a pretty cool idea, though.
Oh my god, it's Lucy! Hi, Lucy! I'm playing a game that's...
It's okay. It's a tram simulator. Okay, this is trying to bite off of Bioshock a little too much. It's called Blues and Bullets, and it's supposed to be like Telltale games, but you play Elliot Ness in the 40s. But so far, all I've done is ruin somebody's burger, kill a whole bunch of gangsters, when I shouldn't have, probably, and now I'm checking into a hotel. And he walks so slow, and there's no way to speed him up. Oh, he was also creeping on some hotel guests, or not guests, I think they worked there. Just... Can I do it? Can I, like, just creep on all of them? Nope, it was just the two with the tattoo.
I'm afraid I can't come with you.
Perfect.
Thanks for the pie.
But...
Welcome to the Grand Hindenburg Hotel. My name is Susan, and I'm glad to be of service. Your name, please?
Mr. Untouchable.
In that case, I suggest you try not to live up to your name if you want to make the most of your stay at the Hindenburg, Mr. Untouchable. And now, how can I help you?
She didn't even question it.
There's no Mr. Capone here, Mr. Untouchable.
Let's go with Domineering.
Listen, Susan, I don't know if he signed in as Mr. Capone, Mr. Scarface, or Satan himself, but I know he's here. And now you're going to tell me which room he's in, or you're going to have a problem on your hands.
Care for a game of Gwent?
He's in the presidential suite. Top floor at the end of the red carpet.
Oh, that'll be fun to walk up.
Thank you, Susan.
All right.
Have a pleasant stay at the Grand Hindenburg Hotel, Mr. Untouchable.
Did not take my credit card. Did not ask for anything. Just let
your
you go.
Attention, please. The cable car to Santa Esperanza
what
leaves
kind of
in 3 minutes.
Can afford this kind of luxury? Shit. You think it's going to be a quiet day and suddenly the storm hits you?
Man, it looks like the backdrop to, like, a talk show. Yep. That's what it is. All right. Oh, my God. Oh, there's a run. Ah, there's a run. Oh, thank goodness. Can I please... Nope, you're not going to let me... All right, we're going to go here, I guess.
Titus and John.
You can't go in there, sir. They're in rehearsal.
Theater?
Shakespeare's Titus Andronicus. They open in a couple of nights. Perhaps Mr. Capone can get you a ticket?
Capone? He's at this hotel? Gosh, I'd heard the opposite.
She drops Capone's name, and then she did. I don't have a hotel key or anything. Like, where are these stairs? Alright, I'm gonna do this half jog. This old man half jog. Pretend like you want to jog. Up. Nope, I think we looked at that already. That's just down there. Alright. Up we go. Later, Lucy.
Your attention, please.
This is, I hope this game is only like 90 minutes or something. Let's just do laps. Let's do fake laps as Elliot Ness. Come on, get a sweat breaking. It's the Olympics walking. Yeah, that sounds about right.
Hey, Ryan, owner of Ryan Hotels, the visionary who transformed the Hindenburg.
Hey, Ryan.
The aeronautical luxury it is today.
God. Yep, it is. I guess it's an homage to BioShock. A little on the nose, if you ask me.
The window cleaners up here deserve every cent they make. I wouldn't do it for all the money in the world.
They probably lower the Zeppelin before they... Everyone's having the most quiet conversations ever. Listen. Yeah. Now, you know what it would really sound like up there?
I don't remember the last time I did that.
You're above the clouds? This is what it's going to sound like. Oh my god, it's freezing! We're above the clouds! Why did we come out here? That's what it's like out there. And then down there, they're just like, I can't see the fireworks, they're above the clouds. Why would they do that? All right, let's grab a Coke. A Crespo.
Damn. Come on!
Can't catch a break! When am I gonna get a soda? Zero spit. I have a pop filter. It catches all of the spit. All right. Couple of shoes, some red wine. Sounds like some fornication. I thought we were supposed to. Okay. What? Wait a minute. And so one day, my magnificent flying wonder will. So he sees what actually happened, and we're living in the world where... Alright. Let's see if we get a shot of the guy who just stacks the luggage. No more rolling carts. They've phased those out. They realized they had problems with the step part of it, so they just don't bother. Alright. It'll be interesting to see how long this game runs, because... I have no clue. I should have probably looked into that. Okay, this definitely looks like a neat place. I have to fart. Sorry.
What happened here?
There we go.
Nothing to worry about, my good man. What happens on the Hindenburg stays on the Hindenburg.
How can you work in a place like this?
You don't want to know where I worked before this, my good man.
Is he using a Swiffer?
Are you saying the law doesn't apply here?
We're too high up, my good man. The law has always preferred to look down.
Yep, he's got a Swiffer. You're not really doing much there. You're just pushing the blood around.
You never had problems with the police?
Oh, many a one, my good man. In fact, what I'm cleaning up is today's first problem.
Yeah, keep at it. I'm sure you'll get it eventually. It looks like it's crusted over pretty well. What do you got over here? Hindenburg, Japanese garden. Yep. Looks like there's something on fire. Got a nice view. Super choppy. Oh boy. Uh-oh. He's doing crime things. I just saw. Or maybe he's not. No, maybe he is. Charla! King of Knives. This is gonna go poorly. What? Can I? What? Let me get a view. Please let me see what happened. Elliot, what have you done? I can't see. Listen, let's talk to the guy.
I'm sorry.
That'll make up for it. You want to play a game of Gwent?
Man, here's the thing. He hit her, right? Obviously, it's assumed he hit her. She screamed, and everyone gasped. But she only screamed once, which tells me that he hit her somewhere vital, and it ended really quick, and somewhere where she wasn't going to be able to scream anymore. So, like, the neck region. So I'm pretty sure she's dead. And nobody's freaking out. At least that's the logic going on in my head right now. Ooh, the frame rate got even worse. Check out this.
If it wasn't for my habit of checking all possible exits when I walk into the lion's den, I'd be a dead man.
I'm old Al Capone.
You should be rotting in jail.
That's exactly what I've been doing for the last 19 and a half years.
I live up here.
You'll be surprised what a little good behavior can do for a person. You're not gonna ask me for my last words this time? I'm a lot closer to death than when I last saw you. As are you.
Why did you ask me here?
Why did you come?
I wanted to see if you'd improved with age. I'm glad to see the answer's no.
When you said rot in jail, you really meant it, huh? Look, I didn't ask you here to find out who's got the snappiest comebacks. I want to hire you.
What?
I require your services as a detective.
What's your game? Who do you take me for?
Look, Ness.
Really?
My granddaughter Sophia has been kidnapped. When what happened to my son, Vittorio, I put her in a boarding school. She was entered under a false surname, Colombo. Nobody knows who she is.
Nobody?
Only Milton. The man who brought you here, I trust him completely. 2 days ago, a guy turned up at the boarding school. He introduced himself
Exposition.
As Guido Colombo, the girl's uncle, and her new legal guardian.
Guido.
He said her parents had just died in a tragic automobile accident. He produced all the relevant papers, driver's license, the custody document supposedly made out by the father, the death certificates. He explained away the fact that the girl didn't know him by saying he moved to Seattle before she was born.
Any clues?
Well, Sophia was wearing a blue dress with flowers that I personally ordered for her from Italy. She was also wearing white ballet shoes with daisies.
Do I need to know all this, really? I should have a notebook or something, right? Guy,
the school principal said he was tall and slim, in his 50s. No particular accent. Black hair, no beard, no glasses. Well-dressed.
I'm ignoring all of this.
But I know he was hired by one of my old associates. Someone wants to finish me once and for all.
Why would I care about that?
Maybe they want control of what's left of my organization. Maybe they hate my guts.
And I thought I was the only one who still hated you after 20 years. What else have you got?
I got this. And I got you.
You got a bowling shirt? My place is at my diner. And your girl's not there.
Huh. So where should I be looking?
The police.
I'm not a cop anymore. Call the station.
The station? Are you serious? The cops are rotten to the core. I should know. I helped make them that way.
So why me?
20 years ago, I pushed you to the edge. I bought your friends and killed the ones who couldn't be bought. I got you so obsessed with me that your wife ended up leaving you. When you had nothing left, you walked into my house, shot my bodyguards, and pointed a gun at me. You could have killed me. But you chose to take it out on this piano. You're the only honest man I know.
You remember the part where you mentioned you just killed all of the guards. He murdered them. He murdered the guards. So he's not super honest. Okay.
I'll do it. Not for you. For her.
I knew I got the right guy.
Oh, the frame rate.
But I want something in return.
As you can see.
Hold on. Let's see if we can change this. I hate changing this. I can't do it. I'd have to go to the menu. I guess that makes sense. Oh, well. All right. Nice menu. I like the font.
I'm not short of money. Ask. I won't haggle.
You leave Santa Esperanza and the country forever.
It's a deal. I always wanted to die in Sicily, but that's the least of my worries. I don't give a damn what happens to me, Ness. You just saved Sophia.
You're missing an eye.
And you can start by investigating
Carlo Boccherini.
How did you know?
Biggest forger in Santa Esperanza. Wouldn't surprise me if Sophia's so-called uncle's papers were made by him. Besides, he's been cursing your name ever since we put you in jail.
Hey, I treated him like a son.
After you killed his parents.
They were selling booze without my permission. Wait, you know where to find him?
I have a good contact at the station. A girl. Rookie. Straight arrow. Reliable.
A girl? You saying you trust her?
You are such a chauvinist. Do you trust me?
Just take a second.
Deal?
Should I punch him? I could punch him. This is what you get for talking like a cliche mafioso guy. I feel like the chat's going to tell me to punch him. And so I'm probably going to punch him. I just need a little confirmation. Yes.
Deal.
Oh, gee, son of a bitch.
Buddy cop movie.
You're informed at all times, huh? You hear me?
I know you from somewhere.
Yeah, like 10 minutes ago.
Elliot Ness and Al Capone have to live together in an apartment on a Zeppelin.
You're not gonna ask me for my last words.
You
should be running. I'm never going to help you.
Why me?
I'm not asking you to help me.
I'm not a customer. I'll do it. Not for you. For her.
That is the largest moon ever.
This town has become a jungle.
Oh, that's neat. I like this. Oh, I like this dream sequence.
Those who swore to protect us fight to steal the last scraps
of dignity we have left.
And those who should judge them prefer to squabble over their prey. But it wasn't always like this. The Santa Esperanza I was born in was a clean town.
Oh, shoot.
Where it meant something to be a cop.
Oh, this is awesome. I want to play a whole game in this style.
Until he arrived.
Oh my god, I want to play a whole game in this style. This is awesome. I want to see a Max Payne like this. I want another Max Payne. I'm gonna have to replay Max Payne 3 one day.
I'm gonna need help.
Good old Jack or orange juice? Let's go with the orange juice. Gotta keep my mind straight. Let's see, fill her up. It's probably a little warm, room temperature. Let's give it a real sip-a-roo. Can't do both, apparently.
Ness.
Elliot, I found Carlo Boccherini.
I knew you would, Alice.
Who is that?
Write this down. 31 Wicker Avenue in Lakeview.
Thanks.
Who is that?
Nice work.
Elliot, what do you want with him? He's got a hell of a file.
Who is that guy? Guy. Girl. Who's that lady? Who is that lady? What does she do the voice of? Yeah, no, she's the straight-laced cop, but she's been in another game. Sorry,
some
I hit the opposite.
Mail turned up for him at the diner with the wrong address.
Elliot, don't lie to me. I'm a cop. If you go outside the law, I can't protect you.
Alice, I don't have much time.
That's somebody.
I'll let you know how it goes. Thanks.
Who is that?
Tomorrow's going to be a long day.
Oh, nope, it was just whiskey. Apparently I put whiskey in the orange juice bottle as well because I'm a super alcoholic and I put whiskey in all of them. Who is that? Oh, that's gonna kill me now. She sounds so familiar.
31 Wicker Avenue. This is it.
You sure?
I'm sure.
She's been in video
games. That stench of stale grease about you reminds me too much of my old job.
You worked as a waiter?
I was a chef, and not in any old kitchen.
I'm looking it up, by the way.
The maximum security penitentiary on Gore Island. Can't think of a better way to do time. And how do you think I met Alphonse? Playing golf?
Alphonse?
On the subject of cooking, I know your blueberry pie had an extra something. I still don't know what.
Alphonse.
So what now? You got a plan?
Take a look around, in case there's a rear exit. I'll take the main door.
My pleasure.
So here's what I'm gonna tell you. He's gonna die at some point. They're gonna become buddies. He's gonna die. And right on his deathbed, he's gonna tell him what that extra recipe is that put in the blueberry pie. I can just tell that's what's going to happen. It might not be this episode. It'll be later in the season, but I can just sense it. Yeah, no voice in the wiki. It's really annoying
me.
The
fact that a criminal like him can hang up his shingle in broad daylight says a lot about Santa Esperanza.
Was she in Assassin's Creed?
Someone took out sections of the fence. Odd.
Garden gnome.
Interesting taste. Been centuries since a gardener visited this house. Maybe Boccherini's business isn't going too well.
Or maybe he just doesn't care about his lawn. Chairs here. We got tons of chairs. Need chairs? They're all on the lawn. They're not lawn chairs, but the chairs on the lawn. Doorbell. 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 Oh, of course not.
The bell doesn't work. I guess Boccherini doesn't get many visitors. Boccherini? Carlo Boccherini?
Nothing of interest out back.
It's seamless. Sorry. It's your seamless order.
You better come see this, Mr. Ness.
Oh, man. What is it?
I don't know how to describe it.
Somebody looked butchered. Now we load the interior house. Give me a moment to look it up. Oh, who was it? She sounds so familiar.
Ooh. Is that our man?
Boccherini.
My God.
We have to find out who did this and why. Let's go.
You're the detective, Mr. Ness. Besides, Alfonso will want to see this. I'll be right back.
All right. I have to establish how Boccherini died. Maybe the body parts can shed some light on the motive.
Oh, wait. I think I've got a name. Hold on. I think I have a name. Jules de Jong? Faith? Copy. New tab. Batman Arkham Knight. Okay, so there you go. Sacred 3, Killzone Shadowfall, Need for Speed Rivals, Remember Me, Lego City Undercover. None of these are what I... Oh, Need for Speed Most Wanted, I think I kind of remember her voice from. Who else here? Ni No Kuni, additional voices. Probably not that. Driver San Francisco. Little Big Planet. Dead Nation. Need for Speed Hot Pursuit. Just Cause 2. Maybe it's Need for Speed Killzone 2. She plays Faith in Mirror's Edge. Age of Conan. X3 Reunited. Come on, none of these are the ones that are like really... Really? So I guess maybe it was Need for Speed. That's the only game on this list that I remember. And Killzone Shadowfall a little bit. No, I never really played that much of that game. Alright, I think it was Need for Speed. Yeah. Weird. I don't place her voice in that, but I guess it makes sense. Okay, so what are we looking for? The murder. The cause of the murder. I'm pretty sure it's all of the spikes through his body. What are we doing? Resume. How does this work? Do I get my mouse? No, no mouse. I don't get to... A and D are doing nothing, so let's just tab out.
Holy Christ. Whoa. What the hell are we up against?
Okie dokie.
His eyes were pulled clean out of their sockets. Whoever did this, it wasn't their first time. And if they committed any other murders like this... It's likely that the police found some of the bodies. I must remember to ask Alice.
This is what you would see in the jump scare screen in, like, a game. Like a Five Nights at Freddy. Blah, 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 and then make a...
His teeth were all pulled out before he was killed.
Ew.
The buildup of blood inside his mouth speaks for itself.
Ew. Maybe also the lack of teeth. kind of. Wait, they're... Oh. Oh, look at that. Oh!
This isn't a cut. It's a tear. His hands were ripped off. Who has that kind of strength? Pity he won't last till Christmas, because he'd almost pass for a tree. There's no doubt the murderer took his time.
Do I not get to go up? Can't go down? Why give me W, A, S, and D if really just A and D is all I need, apparently? What do we got here?
Once he got stuck in there, looks like the bottom of a glass. It's Boccherini, no doubt about that. Although the one I remember was more together.
Cool. Let's see what happens now with the clues. I can't... Oh, E. All right. Mutilation, yep.
Boccherini's teeth were all pulled out. What looks like the bottom of a broken glass buried in Boccherini's back.
Okay, I guess I am not supposed to use that?
The murderer tore Boccherini's hands off. Hands ripped off, teeth torn out. I guess I'll have to rule out criminal intent or personal angle. Boccherini's eyes still haven't shown up. What if I look for whatever was used to remove them?
Sort of a neat method of detective work.
The blood comes from the other side of the corridor and ends next to the body. He was attacked in the other room and dragged to the hall.
Interesting. We'll save our clues a little bit. We don't need to jump in every time.
The evidence suggests that the events began in the lounge. How did Boccherini encounter his murderer?
Okay. Hold on one quick second, folks.
Hey, Windows.
Whatever crushed the table must have been really heavy. Or maybe it was thrown extremely hard.
Maybe it was a body.
I like this move around to see other things. But there really is no need for that W or S.
Fingernails scratched the wood.
And I like how it tells you how many clues there are, so I know when to stop.
A perfectly circular dint, as if someone had tried to hammer in a gigantic bolt, around 4 inches in diameter.
Or a glass.
Or maybe, okay. So, glass is on the table. He was thrown onto the table. That's why the glass is in his back. And then it broke because he was all bleedy. And I don't know. I can't speak towards the last part there about the scratches. What else do we have? Anything else down here? Bottle, lamp. Oh, blood.
Blood ran like water.
Great. We got those clues. Let's see how they fit into things. Let's go to the assault.
A broken table, scratched and covered in blood.
Got that wrong, apparently.
Two pools of blood, one on either side of the dining room table.
I'm just picking all of them because there seems to be no repercussions for not.
The trail of blood from the dining room to the hall.
Maybe if I do it enough, it'll take it.
Nope. Okay, maybe not.
What looks like the bottom of a broken glass buried in Boccherini's
Okay,
bag.
None of them. All right. They're all useless clues. Oh my gosh, this would make for a perfect Brock cop.
Kind of a graphic Brock cop, though.
Did it break during the struggle, or was it already broken? Blood. Blood everywhere. What kind of person takes off a wristwatch without unfastening it? Or fastens the strap again after taking it off?
Brock cop thinks maybe the watch fell off after his hands got ripped off. Seems kind of obvious. What do we got over here?
This was opened recently.
Mm-mm. Papa needs a little juice to get his investigation on. What Brock Cop really wants to know is, why was this room have two ceiling fans so close to each other? It seems kind of redundant. Brock Cop thinks it's a waste of electricity, but Brock Cop's not one to judge.
Glass on the floor indicates the window was broken from outside.
Brock Cop's gone to basic detective school. Oh, look at that.
There's something under there.
Let me grab at it. Alright, I'm gonna get all
wind up under there.
All my fingerprints on it first. Is it loaded? Oh my gosh. There is one in the chamber. Do not pull the trigger. Pow pow. Alright. Yeah, no, that's fully loaded.
Not one round fired. It must have happened fast.
See what we got in the kitchen here. More orange juice, maybe? Look at that. He was having a plate of pinto beans.
What is it with Italians and olives? They lap those things up like caviar.
Hey, don't be a bigot. Is it bigotry to say Italians like olives? I
can't. Have put these into soak. Hours of scraping to get them clean. Although at this stage, I don't think Boccherini's too worried about that.
Get it? Because he's dead? Because he's super dead right now?
Four glasses. Two of water, two of wine.
So he wasn't eating alone.
I've always been a whiskey man, but I know a good wine when I see one.
1952, this takes place in the 50s, so it can't be that old, so...
Leftover lasagna. And it looks good. Why is it that two out of three Italian gangsters are great cooks? I'll never understand what the deal is with them in cooking.
What do I have against Italians, apparently?
Boccherini had company for dinner.
What is it with Italians and company?
One knife's missing. The biggest one.
What is it with Italians and knives? They're always using them to cut their food. Who puts their milk on a shelf like that?
Shut from the inside.
Kick it. Okay, what else can we explore? Excuse me. He looks like a monster from he looks like a Dark Souls monster.
Tear that out, or several.
YouTube test stream probably tomorrow, because it'll have to be Disney related. Because I only have those things unlocked for Rob Plays That Game. So those games I'm waiting on. Let's see if any of our new. See if any of our new clues. Nope, wrong one. Assault.
Pieces of glass from the window in the hall found inside the house. A pistol, fully loaded.
I'm so glad I don't have to listen to what he has to say.
The lamp, torn off its brackets and blocking the stairs. Dirty plates, glasses, and silverware from a dinner for two.
All right.
Try this one. Kitchen,
yeah, I didn't think that one would do it. Alright, we got two out of three. What is it about two out of three Italians and being able to solve mysteries with clues?
Jammed shut from the inside. Maybe between the two of us when Milton gets back. I'm not mistaken, this door opens onto the same room as the locked door in the kitchen.
You didn't even try the doorknob. You just went straight into pushing it. Oh god, it's the eyeball tool. Ooh, gross. Ugh. Yep, that looks like eye goop.
Blood and some kind of sticky liquid.
A teaspoon stained with blood and some kind of sticky... The mixture of sticky liquid and blood can only mean one thing. The spoon was used to remove Buccarini's eyes. The mutilations and the disappearance of his eyes suggest two possible motives. Psychopathy or cultist fanaticism. Which is it?
Quantum Leap? I gotta get into the mood to do... Those are tough, because they're all improv, and I've been so tired lately with work that I haven't been in the mood for it, and I've been wanting to stream more. I will do more Quantum Leap. I just need to get into it. I also need to find the right game that I'm not streaming, which is tough. But I will figure something out. This week was killer, just because between the Criminals in Cars episode and then the Disney Magic or the Disney Wonder Tour and then the Disney vlog and then that Sims episode, it was just like a super heavy editing week. So like I spent so much time editing that I didn't have a lot of time to do much else.
Oh, shit.
Oh.
I should have stayed in my diner.
That's definitely an occult thing right there. This whole thing's a clue. Oh, it's a monster. This is the church. This is the steeple. Open it up. What? What? What?
What is that?
Okay, so occult, I believe, is the answer.
A sick altar of human flesh. Some kind of symbol drawn in blood. Although I don't know the origin of the symbol in the bathroom and the altar of flesh and teeth, I'd say the motive was some kind of occult religion. The big question is, who did it? Looks like a ritual. What was Boccherini mixed up in?
Man, he's getting his footprints all over the crime scene. Should have called it in. What do we got around here?
This knife. Car looks too classy for a forger like Boccherini. Are there sufficient reasons to believe that when the murderer attacked Boccherini, there was someone else in the house?
Yeah.
The first possibility to be ruled out is that the car belonged to Boccherini.
Okay. But we have evidence that someone else is there.
Plates. Someone drove a long way.
Right, so that's one of them. Now we need another clue. Okay, not getting any over there. Guess over here. Let's see what's in the car.
Let's take a look in the glove compartment.
Cultists make sense because of the beginning of the game.
Bingo.
Bingo. Cigarette case. It's the children. No clues here. There they go.
That would be one of the Boccherini clan. A car with Vermont plates. The initials OB on a cigarette case. One, it has Vermont plates. Two, it's too luxurious for a criminal of his standing. Three, the initials on the cigarette case don't match his name. The next possibility that needs to be ruled out is that the car was stolen. There should be evidence that there was someone else in the house.
Yeah, there is.
Dirty plates, glasses, and silverware from a dinner for two. The dirty dishes and glasses prove that Boccherini ate lasagna with one other person. Was Boccherini's guest still in the house when the murderer showed up?
Whoops, wrong button.
What is it with Italians and having guests over to eat?
I also notice... Is it going to unlock new clues around here that I haven't seen before? Stepping around in the blood. Squishy, squishy. Any other evidence? Any other evidence? Oh, the door, maybe. Oh, I don't have... Is the door not a...
What looks like the bottom of a broken glass buried in Boccherini's back.
Why would that prove that someone else was there?
A broken whiskey glass found in the dining room.
I don't get that.
It seems clear that Boccherini and his guest were drinking when the murderer took them by surprise. The real question is, what happened to the witness? Did they escape? Did the murderer take them? Or are they still in the house? A door in the corridor jammed shut. It opens onto the same room as the locked door. A door in the kitchen, locked from the inside. One locked door could be a coincidence, but two locked doors which open onto the same room can't be. Either I'm completely wrong, or the witness is in that room. But I need Milton to open one of those doors.
Detective Ness, Mr. Ness, this is all very linear. You really didn't need to do this whole thing with the string and the crazy conspiracy theorist stuff.
Alright, where's their buddy? I'm just gonna call him Blueberry Pie because I don't remember his name. And I need him to help me open the door. Blueberry Pie, where are you? Okay. Yeah, this is a pretty long... What are we going now? An hour and a half? It's about on par with the Telltale episode. I'm wondering if there's going to be another trial or case or detective bit after this, or this is all of episode one. What do I do? Is there anything here I need to fill in? Oh, yeah, the assault. Let's try all of them.
Torn off its brackets and block an open bottle of whiskey. I'd say Boccherini was drinking in the dining room when his assailant burst in through the window. Boccherini pulled his gun, but the murderer disarmed him before he could shoot. Where did the torture begin?
The table.
A broken table, scratched and covered in blood. Two pools of blood. One on either side of the dining room table. The trail of blood from the dining room to the hall. The lamp. Torn up.
Can't be the watch. Wristwatch. Oh, because...
The bloodstains show that the murderer began to torture Boccherini on the dining table itself. That was where his hands were torn off. As a result, his wristwatch fell to the ground. How did the body reach its current position? The trail of blood from the dining room to the hall. The lamp, torn off its brackets and blocking the stairs. Boccherini,
all of them.
Already minus hands, was dragged into the hall, where the murderer used the brackets of the lamp to complete his macabre diorama.
I always thought it was called macabre when I was in high school.
Pew, 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 pew. Who is it?
Ness,
wrong order.
Me?
Wrong order. Oh, man.
It was open. Why did you ring?
I thought I should use the doorbell so I wouldn't startle you.
Wait a minute.
When I came in, I pressed the doorbell and it didn't work.
That.
Well, in light of the facts, I deduced that it was your finger that wasn't working. So, what can you tell me to restore my faith in you as a detective?
What is that?
It's a camera.
Not a good start. It's a camera. So Alphonse can see all this.
All right. Follow me. Boccherini had company for dinner. Someone from Vermont with the initials OB. Someone whose social status was a lot higher, but who was on the same side of the law. He served lasagna, and after clearing away the dishes, they opened a bottle of whiskey in the dining room.
That was when the murderer burst in on them, coming through the window, which he broke with his own body weight.
It's Nightcrawler.
Boccherini, or maybe his guest, pulled a gun, but it was a waste of time. The murderer was so fast, he was disarmed before he could fire. He focused his attention on Boccherini, totally ignoring the guest, and lifted him up into the air. He then threw him against the dining room table so hard that one of the glasses of whiskey was embedded in Boccherini's back. He span around, clawing at the table, and immediately afterwards the murderer ripped off his hands. I have no idea how he did it, but all the evidence suggests he just pulled. Blood sprayed everywhere. The wristwatch fell to the ground. He dragged him through the corridor into the hall. He tore down the lamp, hung him from the brackets, and stabbed steel rods through his body. He skewered him on the iron bars, possibly taken from the fence outside, and pulled out his teeth one by one. Then he pulled his teeth out one by one as he died. Finally, he scooped out his eyes with a teaspoon. Boccherini must have been dead when the murderer went to the bathroom with his hands and his teeth.
Where are the
then
eyes?
He arranged them to make an altar, weaving the fingers together and placing the teeth inside. Next, he painted something on the wall in blood, a symbol which I don't recognize, but which could have some kind of ritualistic significance. When he'd finished his artwork, he left. I don't know what he did with the eyes.
You're telling me that someone did all this armed with a teaspoon?
More or less.
And you worked all this out on your ownsome, just by looking?
More or less.
On your ownsome.
I don't know which of the two of you scares me more.
But seriously, what's that thing in your hands?
What about the guest?
Right. Come with me. Nothing.
Turns out Mr. Untouchable isn't infallible. But you were close. Congratulations.
This must be Boccherini's office. Let's take a quick look around.
All yours.
I'm working on the Hunger Games.
Why is he... No, I've got work to do. You enjoy your book. Couldn't have that opening. Two of the clues, really the latches? Okay. Third is the money! Look at all that money!
Jesus, there's at least $1 million here.
Mm-hmm. Boccherini's?
I'd be surprised. Probably his guests, and I doubt it was to pay Boccherini for his services. None of his forgeries are worth that much.
Is it real? We could just take the money and go. A note.
Carlo, I have the goods for OB, but I have to take the children to school tomorrow and I can't make the meetup. Friday, same time, same place. It's signed NI.
Mm-hmm. These initials are getting to be a pain in the ass, right?
Yeah.
I have to take the kids to school tomorrow. I don't think this is some loving divorced daddy, Milton.
I take back what I just said.
The driver's license of one John Martinson and Osmond Burke.
OB.
Do we know him?
The eldest son of the richest family in Vermont, convicted rapist. He was arrested thanks to the testimony of his father, who wound up disinheriting him. He escaped from prison last week. He broke into the family home and slit the throats of all his relatives one by one, opened the safe, and got away with a fortune.
They don't make jails like they used to. All
Man.
Starting to add up, isn't it?
Whoa!
Milton!
You're doing fine on your own, Mr. Ness. I believe in you.
Cool camera work.
Ah!
Oh, why aren't you letting me smack him? Aww. Here we go. Give me the punches. Give me the punches. Nope. Okay, I get nothing. Why would you throw him to the knife? Why would you do that?
Get out of my way, I said! He's coming back!
Who's coming back?
Him! The monster!
The guy who killed Boccherini?
He was a monster! Oh, get your hands off me, Negro!
Wow.
What is he like? Describe him for me.
He was a monster. Red and black. I mean, his head reached the ceiling. He tore off his hands with his claws. It was a monster. A monster.
Should I hit him again?
Burke, shut up. You're Osmond Burke, right?
Yes.
Good. Now pay attention, Burke, because I have a question for you.
What? Why is your face all weird?
Who is this money for?
Nikolai Ivankov.
Rings a bell.
One of Capone's right-hand men 20 years ago. What does this stuff about kids mean?
I don't know.
Calm down, Burke. You were going to meet up with him, right?
Yes, at the docks, berth 42, right next to where the Alligator 3 is moored.
So what's the meetup time?
Tomorrow at noon.
Tomorrow?
It's good voice acting.
It's going to be tonight. Don't get too comfortable. We'll be there in no time. There are certain types of people I don't allow in my diner. But today, I have no choice but to make an exception.
I'm afraid not, Mr. Ness. I have to take him to Alphonse.
Out of the question. I know his temper. He'll beat him to a pulp.
Listen, if the missing girl was your granddaughter, you wouldn't forgive me if I didn't let you see the only suspect who could lead us to her.
Okay.
Shucks.
What?
I thought that bloodbath would cover up the smell of stale grease. I was wrong.
Nightfall. I tried to look up on how long to beat how long this episode is, but there's no information. The game's too new. So, I don't know. I guess we'll find out. We'll be the pioneers of Blues and Bullets.
Elliot?
Delphine.
Oh, thank God you're here. The lights were off, so I thought... I'm sorry. I got out of the hospital late, then I went to the station to pick up Jim's check, and when they told me...
Hey, Kelso!
I'm scared.
Of what?
What are you drinking?
Juice.
It's only juice.
It's just juice.
And nothing else.
Nothing.
Breathe
no whiskey. No, it's just juice.
You heard me. I'm sorry. It hasn't been a good day.
What's happened?
Don't look at it.
You knew.
Knew about what?
What's that gun doing there?
It's a secret? What should I do? Lie, half truth, or secret? I'm going to let you guys pick. Look at it. Until then, it's just a really awkward staring competition between the two of them, in which they're both losing because they're both blinking. Half-truth was the first answer.
A guy I know is having trouble with a two-bit mafioso. He asked me to go with him, just in case. I didn't have to get it out.
Well, don't. Don't start taking on the mafia. Not now. You really don't know?
No, I don't know. And if you keep up the guessing games, I'll never know.
He's back.
Who?
Him.
Alphonse.
I don't know why it still surprises me, but it's incredible that you were such a good detective, and yet you've never been able to understand people.
Or cameras. It was weird.
Capone got out of jail.
Where do you hear that?
Chief Jenkins.
Chief Jenkins?
The same guy who said he was going to clean up Santa Esperanza, right? In that case, you can rest assured Capone just put on his striped pajamas, and in 4 minutes' time, he'll be snoring in his cell.
Elliot, what if it's true? If he's out, what's the first thing he's going to do? Who does he hate more than anyone?
The jury, I guess.
If it's true he got free, which I doubt, the first people he'll want to take out are the ones who put him in jail, the members of the jury. And if my memory serves, there were a lot of them. It'll take him a long time to get to me.
Please, Elliot, don't joke. You're the only part of Jim's life that I have left. If you put yourself in danger, I... Please, no.
Aw, rejected.
My hand? I burnt it cooking. Fried eggs are the devil's work.
What's going on?
Burnt my knuckles on the stove.
We're closed.
Can you wait outside for a couple of minutes, Milton?
Sure, of course. Although, I'm sorry to say, but we're short on time.
Elliot.
The case.
Come in, Milton, come in. Delphine, I'll tell you later. Now...
You said you'd never treat me like that again. I'm glad I could confirm that you're okay.
No, and it's none of your business.
What was Sorry, that?
Buddy. I've brought your rapist costume for the party.
One? What? Two? What? Since when is this the international Seriously, symbol for getting together?
No, she's the wife of a friend who died in the line of duty, Jim Dockers.
Alphonse told me about him.
Your Alphonse killed him.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Mr. Ness. Although he's not the same man he was. Anyway, isn't a deal with marriage until death do us part?
It's not that simple. There are other factors.
I wasn't listening. I was looking at a tweet. Shouldn't have done that. Gonna go with loyalty.
Dockers was my best friend. I couldn't do that to him. Not even now he's dead.
Right. So you like her, but you don't have the nerve.
Oh yeah? What would you do?
Women have never been one of my priorities.
I'm sorry?
Forget it. You screwed Alphonse good, didn't you?
I don't think he holds it against me, this far down the line. He's a new man now, right?
Did you enjoy it?
I'm a cop.
Turns around. Oh, a cop. Changing the bathroom.
You do the job you're given. End of story.
I hear you. But you didn't finish the next job they gave you. Did they find those kids?
No. How do I look?
Like the invisible man in the movie. No one's gonna buy it.
Take it easy. Everything's going to work out fine.
So does that mean that guy they found is like naked in the trunk right now? And why do you call it a rapist costume? That guy isn't a rapist, right? All right, looks like there's a second level. Man, this is going on. We're heading on 2 hours almost. I mean, I'm all about playing episodic games until the end of the episode, so we'll keep playing. Unless it's like 6 hours, then we will not. I suspect there's going to be a shootout here. Maybe. No, we're going to walk in, but we're going to have to shoot our way out. That's what I'm suspecting. Get twice the use of the level if you have them go back the other way.
So, everything's gonna work out fine, huh? You sure it's here?
Relax. It's just a little further. Just follow me.
This plan is suicidal. We're gonna die.
I don't think so.
And may I ask why?
It's not the first time I've done a job like this, and I never was any good at getting killed.
It's the first time for everything, my friend.
Milton, if you go on contradicting me, you're not going to get into your role. Don't forget, while we're here, you're supposed to be at my beck and call.
While we're here.
Hear that? Not bad.
A white boy who likes the blues. What's next? You gonna let the black man vote?
I hate when historical movies and shows and games do that. They do the whole, like, wink, wink. Let's joke about something that we know happens. Oh, I feel a fart come in. There's another silent one. I could have gotten away with it. Wasn't for my big mouth. Oh, got a couple there getting hot and heavy. Oh, someone's coming.
Hey, you. Where do you think you're going?
Later, Noah.
Hello, friend. I've come to speak with Nikolai Ivankov. Can you help me?
I'm sorry, pal. The Mummy Repair Center is over on the other side.
He's probably a burn victim.
Being polite.
Kick him in the balls, honey.
It'd be my pleasure, sweetie chops.
Dakota.
Yeah, my pleasure, Miss Dakota.
Listen, friend, I've had to freeze my ass off on guard duty myself. Let me and my man pass, and you can carry on warming yourself up.
The other option is for us to warm him up ourselves, Mr. Burke.
Ah, you got one of those uppity Negroes, I see.
Oh, God.
If he's like that with me, think what he'd do with you.
What the fuck? Who the hell do you think you are?
I'm Osmond Burke, and I have an appointment with your boss.
You're Burke? Why didn't you say so before?
Come on in! It's like Wizard of Oz. Totally gonna have to shoot my way out of here. I can't run, and it's killing me. Video being choppy, also killing me a little bit. Shaping container at a docks.
You really want to know? Better off not asking.
It's the monster. I'm gonna have to fight that monster on my way out. He's gonna burst right through those doors when I'm walking down that gangplank. Let's see how many of these guesses end up being right.
It's supposed to be here.
Where's the ship?
Looking for someone.
We arranged to meet Nikolai Ivankov at berth 42, but it looks like the ship isn't moored here. Has she set sail?
It isn't moored? Maybe she sunk to the bottom of the ocean.
Is there that much depth to a docked area for a submarine to submerge? Turn on all the lights so that this remains the most covert operation ever. Oh, no kidding. Oh, that was the end of the episode. Okay. So around an hour and a half long. That's not bad. So, let me throw my two cents, I guess, in on this so far. Tom Clark Hill, Michael Clark Duncan. It's interesting. You know, the controls feel a little floaty. Moving around doesn't feel very snappy. The QuickTime events are really simplistic. It's just WSAD, and you seem to get plenty of leeway with them, so it doesn't matter if you mess up. Overall, it's interesting. I think it is a great example of how gameplay like this can survive based on a pricing model that is fitting for it. Because if this were part of, like, if this came out as a, you know, 10 or 12 hour experience for $60, I would have passed on this. This feels like a AA game. But as a $5 episodic game, like, I'm cool with it. Like, I'm going to get episode 2. I like this more than I like Life is Strange, despite its flaws, despite the weird writing. So, you know, I think it's smart. I think it's smart the way they broke it up. I think everything looks great. I think the voice acting... I always thought the guy who did Geralt was doing that voice because that's what they wanted Geralt to be, but apparently that's just the voice he does, which seems to have not a lot of character. I hate that in video games. I hate when they take the protagonist and they try and make them like a flat character, sort of like Shepard in Mass Effect, because I guess it makes it easier for the player to project their own emotions on it. But I hate that because it just makes it feel like a dull character. I want to see a character that emotes, and we didn't see much of that here. But I think the premise and the plot and the setting makes up for the lack of characters. There aren't any really deep characters in this story. Yeah, and then there were moments like the dream sequence where you're shooting people and the words are and it was gorgeous. And that's sort of the thing that's going to drive me to get the next episode. I don't know if I'm going to go as far as to get the season pass. You know, they do that whole offer, you pay a little less, you buy all the episodes at once. But for something like this, a developer that I've never really played games for before, I'm not going to do that because I just, you know, maybe this was a one-hit thing and episode 2 sucks. We'll see. So I'm going to take it episode by episode. I'm glad I did that with Life is Strange, because by episode 2 I really wasn't interested anymore, and so I kind of stopped playing. But there you have it. So it is midnight. I'm trying to keep my sleep schedule somewhat normal this weekend, so I'm going to tune out for now. And I actually don't have to work on the channel for once, so I could probably go to bed or something at a normal hour. Thanks for joining me. I will probably stream tomorrow briefly. It will probably be on YouTube just to test out how that is or how that's changed. And then I'll probably stream on Sunday as well, because I'm sort of getting ahead of schedule. I'm going to host Lucy again, I guess, because actually let me see who else is live. So let's quit out of here. I'm just tired. I went to the gym today and I didn't get a ton of sleep, which is a... just like an epilogue? Or is this the menu? Looks like a creepy menu. Oh shoot, there's an epilogue.
You know that we punish children who behave badly, don't you? Yesterday, it was Juliet who behaved badly. Do you remember?
Uh-huh.
She hit Junior so she would finish ahead of him in the morning race. Do you know what we did to her?
Mm-mm.
Don't worry. You'll find out soon enough. Which do you prefer? The doll or the plush toy?
The doll. He's gonna throw it in the fire.
Two days ago, Mickey bit Tom so he could take his food. Do you know what we did with him?
Bruno says you killed him.
Bruno says many things. Which do you prefer, blonde hair or brown?
Brown?
today. You tried to escape. Do you know what the difference is?
No.
Juliet and Mickey hurt their friends so that we would not punish them. You tried to escape, but you did not harm your friends. You even tried to help Bruno, although in the end you chose, very wisely, to save yourself. We are going to punish you.
With freedom.
But in a different way than Juliet and Mickey. Bruno, on the other hand, did something very similar to them. He betrayed you to avoid being punished.
I'm sorry.
Which of these two drawings do you like best?
I'm sorry!
What? Oh my gosh, props for the developers to have the balls to cut off a kid's hand. Whoa. Whoa.